क्लास 8। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू चैप्टर नंबर 3 एल्गोरिथम्स एंड फ्लो चार्ट। इन दिस चैप्टर आई विल एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज एल्गोरिथम एंड व्हाट इज फ्लो चार्ट, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ गुड एल्गोरिथम, सिंबल्स विच वी आर यूजिंग इन टू मेक अ फ्लो चार्ट एंड सम सॉल्व एग्जाम्पल्स ऑल्सो, एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द शॉर्ट आंसर्स एंड मल्टीपल च्वाइस क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो इन दिस वीडियो। लेट्स स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 3 एल्गोरिथम्स एंड फ्लो चार्ट। फर्स्ट आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग व्हाट इज एल्गोरिथम। एन एल्गोरिथम इज डिफाइंड एज अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ इंस्ट्रक्शन दैट आर रिक्वायर्ड टू गेट द डिजायर्ड रिजल्ट्स। These instructions are written in simple English in different steps. It helps to develop the fundamental logic of a problem and is an effective method for solving different problems, for example, mathematical problems also. We can say that algorithm is a sequence of the instructions, and we will write that instruction step by step, and we will write that instruction in our simple English language. This is known as the algorithm. Now, characteristics of a good algorithm. Each step of an algorithm must be precisely defined. An algorithm must contain blocks. It should accept a set of inputs and produce a defined output. It must be terminated after a finite number of steps. If they are using many steps, then it will be terminated also. It should be independent from a computer programming language. Algorithm is independent from a computer programming language. It should develop a platform for writing a program. Means we can write our program. Characteristics of a good algorithm. Begin the algorithm with the word start. Give a number of each instructions. Write each instruction in a separate line. Each instruction should be written in simple English. The algorithm should finish with the word stop. When we are starting to write algorithm, it will be start by the word of start. And when we finished that algorithm, it will be finished by the word stop. In between start and stop, we will write our instructions, but using the separate lines to write an instruction. For example, write an algorithm for visiting a book fair. If you want to go a book fair, how to write an algorithm? Now, first step, start. After second step, go to the ticket counter. Third step, pay money for the ticket. First, we will want to buy tickets. Step 4, get the ticket from the counter. Step 5, show your ticket at the entrance. 6, visit the bookstalls. After that, stop. This is the algorithm for visiting a book fair. Now, flowchart. A flowchart is a pictorial representation. That is the stepwise algorithm is an stepwise representation. But flowchart is a pictorial representation of an algorithm. It uses boxes of different shapes to represent different types of instructions. These boxes are connected with arrow marks to indicate the flow of operations. Features of flowchart. It is an easy method of communication. Yes, we can because by seeing flowchart, we understood the method which we have used in flowchart. It is independent of programming language. No need to any programming language. It is the key to correct programming. It helps to plan and design a new system. It clearly indicates the task to be performed at each level. Now, symbols used in flowchart. A flowchart uses boxes of different shape to denote different types of instructions. Now, I am telling you this is the terminal box. Terminal box are using for beginning and for ending of a flowchart. They are oval or rounded rectangle. they are the start box using for beginning the flow chart, and this is the end of flow chart. Now input output box. These boxes are used to represent an input which we have given to the program, and output which result will come, that is output operation of a task, the IO. We can say it IO box. The IO box is represented by a parallelogram. This is the shape, of this box is in parallelogram, so that by parallelogram they are representing. This is the input and output box. Process box. This box is used to represent all types of mathematical task or calculation. This box is rectangle in shape. All type of mathematical addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, these are task calculation written in this type of rectangle box. This is known as the process. By processing, addition processing, subtraction, multiplication, all processing are doing in this type of boxes. Now decision box. This box is used to direct a decision that has to be made. A decision box is in the shape of a rhombus or a diamond. It is the shape of this box is rhombus or diamond. Symbols are used to take decision. There we can use the symbols greater than, less than, less than and equal to. This type of function used in this the take decisions. Now flow lines. These are the flow lines. That arrow is the flow lines. Flow lines are used to indicate the direction of flow of instruction. The direction of an instruction is either from top to bottom or from left to right. Direction is only in two here, top to bottom and left to right. Draw, by this example I am explaining, draw a flow chart to find the area of a rectangle. First we will write the algorithm. First, step 1, start. Step 2, accept the length and breadth. Step 3, use the formula area is equal to length multiply breadth and store the result. Step 4, display the area of the rectangle. Now, by the name of this start box and this stop box is in rectangle shape. So that we have made this box in, oval shape. Oval or rounded shape. We have written start and stop in this type of box. Then this is the accept, this is the input, and display the result is output. So that we will make a parallelogram box for this is input and this is the output. We will write the input, take the length and breadth, and display the area here. Now this use the formula. Now this is the process box. So that we will use the rectangle box for processing. Area is equal to length multiply breadth. This is the flow chart to find the area of a rectangle. Now we will do some questions, some multiple choice question which are based on the flow chart and algorithm. Question number 1, the symbols dash, IO, flow, terminal, decision. The symbol denotes terminal. It is used to define the way. Explanation: the symbol denotes a terminal. It is used for indication of start and stop nodes of a program. I have written the explanation why we are using the answer, the option of these questions. In computer science, algorithm refers to a pictorial representation of a flow chart. This is true or false? This is false, because algorithm is a stepwise representation. The statement is false. The correct statement would be, in computer science, flow chart refers to a pictorial representation of an algorithm. Question number 3, the process of drawing a flow chart for an algorithm is called DES. Performance, evolution, algorithmic representation or flow charting. This is answer is flow charting, because the drawing a flow chart is known as the flow charting. It is called as flow charting. A flow chart is nothing but a pictorial representation of an algorithm. Question number 4, actual instruction in flow charting are represented in dash, representing circles, arrow, boxes or lines. They are represented in flow charting, instructions are representing in boxes, not arrow, not circle. Boxes are connected by using arrow to indicate the exact flow of a flow chart and the order in which they are to be executed. Next, the following boxes represents decision, initialization IO, decision boxes, because I have written that type of box, that is the decision box, which is in shape in rhombus or diamond. A diamond shaped box denotes the decision making statement. It jumps to a truth value or a false value. 6. A box that can represent two different conditions. Rectangle, diamond, circle, parallelogram. It is a diamond because this is known as the decision box. Because in decision box, we can write two different conditions. A diamond shaped box denotes either a truth value or a false value. It jumps onto two different statements following it by flowchart. There should be certain set standards on the amount of detail that should be provided in a flowchart. This is true or false? This is false. Because there should be no set standards on the amount of detail that should be provided in a flowchart. A detailed flowchart is called DES. Stack, macro, micro, union. It is known as the micro. A detailed flowchart or a flowchart with more details is called as micro flowchart. It represents all the components of the algorithm that is followed. Now, which of the following is not an advantage of a flowchart? Better communication, efficient coding, systematic testing, improper documentation. Answer is improper documentation. Because better communication we can do by a flowchart, efficient coding also doing by flowchart, this is also the advantage of flowchart, systematic testing is also doing by the flowchart. Only improper documentation is not an advantage of a flowchart because it also provides systematic debugging. Now question number 10, a flowchart that outlines the main segment of a program. Macro, micro, union. A flowchart outline is known as the macro. The answer is macro flowchart because a macro flowchart outlines the important component of a program. It therefore shows fewer details. These are the questions based on the flowchart and algorithm. You will read your chapter thoroughly and do the exercise which are given back side of your chapter. So you will prepare that exercises also, because the MCQ questions which will come in your exam are coming from the chapter, in between the chapter, and that MCQ question based on that exercises also, so that you will prepare that exercises and chapters thoroughly. Thank you.